It's beautiful.
I thought you might like it.
I've always loved stars.
Why?
It reminds us there's so much beauty out there, which we almost never see.
Because we're blinded by what's in front of us.
Exactly. But then I learned the truth. The stars we're seeing have already been dead for millions of years. They're all lies.
But that doesn't make them any less beautiful, right?
I don't know. If they're not even real, then what's the point? It's all lies. Everything. My entire life. My dad. My mom. If I can even call her that anymore. And that other woman, my real mom, she's the biggest lie of all. I can't trust any of them. I think you're the only one in the world I can trust.
I'll take it. Even if it's only by process of elimination.
Good. I wore this bracelet my entire life. I never even asked why. Never even thought about it. Somehow, I think I always knew. Even when I didn't know. That my real mother was gone. The fact that she's here right now, that she came here for me. I think I need to see her. Is that wrong?
Of course not. But it might be tough to track her down.
Yeah. That's true. Luckily, I've got my secret weapon. But what if we can't find her? It's not like I can ask my dad. I have no idea where to start.
I think I know what to do. I'll call Frank and get him to connect us to her.
You do that?
I'll give it a shot.
Of course, even if we know where she is, we need a way to get to her. I can't just ask my parents for a ride.
Don't worry. I've got that one covered too.
You do?
Yep. In fact, anything you could come up with, I'll handle it.
I know you will. But even if we find her, how will I talk to her? What do I say?
After my dad died, I was worried I wouldn't know how to talk to him anymore. But somehow, when we speak, I always know what to say.
When you speak?
In my dreams. He's there. And it's so real. It's almost like it's another part of my life. It used to be the only part that mattered. I've never told anyone about that. Weird, huh? Rachel?
I was just thinking. Maybe I was wrong before. Who cares if the stars are dead? As long as we can still see them, that means they're real. To us. Right?
Right. I think we're stuck. Hey, maybe you should let me drive. You always do it wrong.
That was one time. When are you going to let it go? Remember when we used to work on cars together? Those are some of my favorite memories.
We never... That wasn't... you.
Could have sworn that was me. All right, you win. Why don't you go take a look?
You sure?
What's wrong? Don't you see anything?
Fine. It's the spark plug.
No, that's not it. I just had that replaced.
Isn't improv supposed to be all about yes and?
Yes and what?
Dad, stop. None of this is real. You're not real. Rachel's family isn't real. This whole thing, it's all just theater.
Well, you know what William Shakespeare said.
Something about the whole world being a stage, so might as well act the fuck out of it.
Nailed it.
But I don't want to be an actor. I just want to be myself. Give me a break.
Well, maybe there's a reason we pretend. Maybe the lies we tell each other are less horrible than the truths we keep hidden.
Wow. That's pretty dark, Dad.
Where do you think you get it from? There's my cue.
Dad?
Relax, sweetie. It's all pretend, right?
Right.
Just a bit of stage magic. Floodlights, sound effects. Chloe, look at me. Look at me, sweetheart. It's going to be okay.
Wait, what the shit? Has someone been going through my room? Doesn't seem like Mom. She wouldn't leave a mess like this. Wait. David? That motherfucker. Whatever. I don't have time for this shit. I've gotta help Rachel. Okay, I saw Sarah leaving Frank's RV. He might know how to find her. Plus, he likes me, and he owes me one from yesterday. I can do this. Come on, dude. Pick up.
Bryce, I got your collector's fee. Coming to get it?
Hey, Frank. I was actually gonna cash in for a favor instead. What do you say?
Never run out of crap, do you? What's the problem?
I need to find that woman who was in your RV yesterday. Frank?
What the hell for?
Something important. Can you help? I would really appreciate it. I'm your favorite client, remember?
I'll meet you in the junkyard in 2 hours.
Sweet. Thanks, man. You're a real... That went well, I guess. What am I getting myself into? Okay, I've got 2 hours to kill. A shower would be fucking amazing. Better than nothing. Figures. What? Nice to see my work is appreciated. A further layer of nuance. Nathan almost pissed himself. Thou art an idiot. Whoa. Skips in a band? So much has changed. I wonder if you'd even recognize me now. Inaccurate as of yesterday. Someone should update this photo. California, huh? Would be cool to see where Rachel grew up. Dad's favorite jacket. Definitely taking that if Rachel and I ever leave. Is Mom playing music? Huh. Is that David's towel? Where the hell is mine? Okay. My towel's probably in here somewhere. I should just calmly look for it. Lots of washcloths. No towel. I truly hate seeing so much of David's shit around here. Gross. No awesome pirate towel. I can't believe Max and I were so into this shit when we were kids. Wait a minute. Captain Bluebeard's hair dye. Max was going to make me a pirate, but we never got around to it. Ready for the best shower of my life. Hot water, don't let me down. All right. One last thing. I need to get Dad's tools so I can fix that truck. Dad's toolbox should be in the garage downstairs. Is getting out of here still in my future? Or is this picture the closest I'll ever get? Either way, we're fixing that truck from the junkyard. One day, I'll look at that and think, huh, my old home. And not, fuck this shithole forever. Shit. David really is moving in. I remember this. Mom loved it. Wait. Is today Mother's Day? Shit. Here goes. What are the chances I can avoid Mom or David?
I'm flipping them over.
Not yet. I told you. 3 minutes each side.
They're gonna burn.
Oh, you're the expert now.
I can't stand it.
I'm telling you, it'll make a mess. You know, you don't have to make me breakfast. I'd settle for flowers.
You cook all the time. I want you to have a break at home.
You are one class act, David Madsen.
Huh. Mom actually looks pretty happy right now.
Hey, who's there?
Hey.
Chloe, your hair. When did you... Was this for the play? I heard you performed last night.
Nope. I mean, I did. But this is something different.
None of that matters now. Oh, I am so glad to see you.
Good to see you, Chloe. Coming home was a smart decision.
Happy Mother's Day, Mom.
Thank you, sweetheart.
I didn't get you anything.
Having you back home is present enough.
I'm just here to pick up something. Then I have to go.
Are you coming home tonight?
Mom, I don't know.
I wish you would tell me what you're up to.
I'm just hanging out with Rachel.
Oh, how is Rachel? I was telling David about the play and you being in it.
I really gotta go.
Listen. Wait. Before you go, David has something to say to you. It won't take but a minute.
Mom.
I don't think this is the best idea.
You already promised.
Chloe, I've made an agreement with your mother to trust you from now on.
Really? What does that mean?
It means that from today forward, I'm going to take you at your word. So, if you say you haven't been smoking or drinking, then I'll just leave you be.
The idea is you should feel comfortable here, Chloe. David's not going to question you, and neither am I.
David's lying to your face, Mom. He searched my room.
You gave up any right to privacy when
Chloe, I asked David to help me yesterday, and he only did what he thought was best.
You knew? You knew that David went through all of my...
That was before I talked to him and explained why I disagreed with that method. But Chloe, if I'd been able to trust you in the first place...
I'm done with this.
Chloe, stop. I know why you're acting this way. And I know you're gonna regret it. Come here. Take a look at this. This is my friend Phil Becker. We served in the same unit. Two tours. Becker was killed near the end of our deployment. Roadside IED. We used to joke about all the trouble we were gonna get into once we got back home. But he died. He died, and I didn't. And I think about that fact every damn day. The point is, I've had my share of grief. I know what you're going through. So I guess what I'm saying is, I'm here to do whatever I can to help you get over the loss of your dad.
Please, I'm begging you. Give David a chance, won't you?
Here. Why don't you keep this photo for a little while? Think about what I've said.
David looks so young. And this Phil guy, they look close. Thank you, David.
Oh, Chloe.
Mom.
I'm just so proud of you both.
Mom, I really need to go.
Be careful out there, Chloe.
I love you, sweetheart.
All right, all right. What the hell? Just gotta grab Dad's toolbox and then get out of here quick. Holy crap. This might actually be helpful for fixing up the truck.
work with me here.
Better, but still needs a bit more love. I can salvage this beast. I just need to find the right tool for each problem.